bit of a late one tonight. And instead of doing the usual, well, actually, no. I've kind of messed up the order of all of the sessions this week already, before tonight. Instead of the usual order, I mean, last week I believe I did chest, then legs, then back, then arms, and it was meant to be the usual legs, chest, back, and arms. But to really mess things up this week, instead of doing legs tonight on Tuesday, I'm doing back. I'm going to do legs tomorrow, which is usually on my rest day, which will be Wednesday. And the reason for that is I actually had every intent on training legs today. I wanted to train legs at Riggs Gym, but because of the way my day unfolded, I couldn't get to Riggs today. And I figured, you know what, instead of having a subpar session and doing legs here when I really wanted to test out the hammer strength hip press, or actually it might be the Rogers hip press. It's one of the two hip press machines anyway. I've still yet to use one, and I've seen people in the UK and the United States use them, and I really like the look of the machine. So instead of just foregoing that another week, I'm going to still train legs at Riggs, but I'll just do it tomorrow. And so just basically rotate the two sessions around, rotate the session order. So tonight it'll be back. And I tell you what, guys, it took every inch of willpower to not drink my Peach Mango Bum Energy. I brought it along with me, and yeah, I had it sitting there in the car, and I was most definitely going to drink it. But I looked at the time and I thought, you know what, I should be a responsible young adult and not have caffeine at 7:15 at night. So I decided not to. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix up some EAAs and have that instead. I just realized I said bought. I meant to say I brought it with me. I bought it the other day. But I brought it along with me. Grammar matters. It's important. So I thought I'd better correct myself. Go 500 mil. I might end up using the rest of it, I'll just wait and see. And gonna go the raw EAAs today instead of the, what's the other one that I've been having a lot lately? EHP Labs, that's right. Strawberry Kiwi. It's a hard flavour to beat, to be completely fair. Just half a scoop of this. Just for the flavour. So yeah, back tonight, and then legs at Riggs tomorrow, which will be good fun. But I went as far as to prep all of my meals today, have them in my cooler bag, everything was ready to go, and then I looked at the time and thought to myself, I've got about 2 hours to play with before I have to go pick my fiance out from the railway station. So I thought, you know what, no, I'm just going to do a little bit of extra work, wait until I have to pick her up, and then just head to the local gym tonight after I picked her up. Because to go to Riggs, it's a bit out of the way. It's like a 45-50 minute drive each way, so you're looking at like easily a 4 hour trek, or like a 4 hour chunk out of your day for a training session there. And that's assuming that you're being efficient with the use of time. So I just thought, you know what, I'll give it a miss. I'll give it a miss today. But that's something to look forward to tomorrow now. And I'm excited to, they've even got the old school Dorian Yates Nautilus chain driven leg extension. I haven't used that thing for ages. They've got one down in Melbourne, which I tried at Doherty's gym. Back around the time of my first bodybuilding show, actually, a few years back. And that was a treat. That was a cool piece of equipment, I'll tell you that. But they've got one of those there. They've got a lot of specialty equipment at Riggs Gym, and they've just got a bunch new equipment, or a bunch more equipment. So you get to see that when I get around to doing that session and recording it, whether it's tomorrow, whether I might have a rest day tomorrow if I'm not feeling up to it, and then do legs on Thursday. But either way, tomorrow or Thursday, legs at Riggs is going down. Yeah, I'll eat these LCM Rice Krispie treat things, and I see you guys in there. The back's probably going to look a lot like just a bunch of pull downs, a little bit of T-bar rows, a little bit of shrugs, and probably throw in a little bit of rear delts as well. So a little bit of reverse cable flies or cross body rear delt flies, basically. Yeah, that's it. I'd say 10 sets of back, 3 to 4 sets for rear delts. Might push it up to 12 sets for back. Yeah, 12 sets of back, I think. So 12 sets of back, and then about 4 sets for shoulders or rear delts. Anyway, see you guys in there. Okay, nice and easy, just same weight as last week. One set down, felt pretty good. I'll probably keep this weight for the remaining sets. Now, in terms of how many, I was originally thinking only 2 because I'm doing 3 vertical pulling movements for the session, but I might do 3 sets of this, just see how things go. See how this second set feels. And even though this isn't like a single arm chest supported pull down, this still targets the lats, regardless what people might tell you, what you might personally think. If you're doing a pulling movement, whether it's vertical or horizontal, it is going to still target the lats. So yeah, don't think that you need to have everything lat biased to hit the lats. Final set of these now, and then we'll be on to the second back movement of the session. Now, contrary to popular belief, you don't have to be doing a chest supported single arm pull down to bias the lats. The exercise I'm doing here right now is actually pretty lat dominant, despite what people might tell you. I mean, the prime movers in this variation of a pull down is the traditional lat pull down bar. Things like your upper back, so your traps, your rhomboids, but then also, secondarily, your lats, go figure. One of the biggest muscles in your back is involved in traditional lat pull down. And then you also get a bit of teres activity in there too, like teres major. So yeah, everything's involved, every part of the back musculature essentially, all the big parts, including the lats. So don't think that you need to be doing all this fancy, shitty looking chest supported single arm vertical pulling to hit the lats or target the lats. Chances are, if you're, I suppose, stressing about those little things, those intricacies so much, you probably don't really have much of a back to begin with. You should just focus on getting variety in your training, just getting stronger over a variety of different pulls in a variety of different planes of movement. And if you do that, eat enough food and prioritize your sleep, and give it enough time, which is the important thing, you're going to have a big back in 5-10 years time. But you can't rush this shit. Everything good, everything worth having in life takes time, and a big back is no exception. get, what I'm going to do tonight is, instead of supersetting these with calcium shrugs, I'll just do them as two separate, two individual exercises, just so I can perform a little bit better on that second exercise, the calcium shrugs, and then also to I guess take a little bit of a breather and allow my grip strength to kind of recoup, because I find, even though I like supersetting this with the calcium shrugs, it's not so much my back that's the rate limiting factor, but rather my grip strength. It seems to be failing me, and I don't want to use straps because I do like to, I guess, train my forearms a little bit more by gripping stuff. And if I don't do them in a superset, my grip isn't the rate limiting factor. It's only when I superset it. So if I do it as a straight set and then get all these out of the way and then do calcium shrugs afterwards, I don't need straps and my grip isn't a rate limiting factor, so it works out better in that regard, I think. And it's better to not rely on straps or use straps if you don't have to. Straps should only be used if grip is a rate limiting factor, and we know from the literature that nothing really beats straight sets. Like, straight sets to close to failure can't really be beaten with intensifier techniques. So, I mean, that's not to say that intensifier techniques are useless. They have a time and a place, but if you have the time allotted to be able to do two exercises in a straight set fashion versus two exercises in a superset fashion with straps, you're probably better off to go with the former, if you ask me. But if time is of the essence, then superset might be a more viable choice or viable option. Second set just then, and I went on a whole spiel about how I might drop the weight back depending on how the set goes, whether I get a decent kind of 8 or 9 reps, or if it's a little bit too sloppy for my liking to warrant keeping it at that weight. But lo and behold, the camera battery died mid-recording, so you guys do not get to see that epic set that I just did. I did a nice quality 9 repetitions with 4 plates. So the first set I did was 3 20 kilo plates, so 60 kilo worth of plates. And then the second set that I just did, which you will never see now because the file is corrupt, was 80 kilos of plates, and I got a good solid 9 reps. So I'm going to keep it at that weight for the third and final set, and then obviously keep it at the same weight for calcium shrugs after that. But yeah, bit of a bummer. I have a feeling that this set is going to be very lackluster, and you're not going to get to see the good one, the set that I just did. That's a shame, but such is life. Sometimes things don't go to plan. It looks like it barely passes for an exercise due to its substantially short range of motion. Calcium shrugs. What else could it be? So, see how this goes. I've got to remember, I've got a real bad tendency of flexing my elbows and using my biceps to kind of assist the movement. which is a common error I think a lot of us run into. Like, I'm not alone when it comes to that, but it's really important that you keep those elbows extended as much as possible, or essentially flex the triceps. That's what I like to do, which I've mentioned in the past. And just try to keep the biceps out of it as much as possible. They're obviously going to isometrically assist the movement, but you want to try to prevent them from going through any kind of level of shortening. It should just be all back.
Drops it.
Proper back exercise of the session, and then it's just a rear delt exercise to finish off. The parallel grip, no, not parallel, the overhand pronated grip, seated cable row. Now, there's nothing special about this attachment, I just prefer it. It's personal preference. I find I can get a lot more upper back involvement when I use this attachment as opposed to a parallel grip where I just get too lat dominant. And I connect really, really easily with my lats. Like, I get almost an instantaneous binder muscle connection with my lats, whereas the upper back's a little bit of a different story. So for me personally, this is a better attachment choice. For somebody else who's very naturally upper back centric with their rowing, they'd probably benefit more from a single arm neutral grip, or I guess you'd say shoulder width pronated grip. Oh, shoulder width. Parallel grip, not pronated grip. You get what I'm saying. I benefit more from like a neutral grip or even a slightly supinated grip, whereas me, I benefit a lot more from an overhand grip if it comes down to what I'm trying to achieve with the exercise, which is to hit more upper back. Body language for my liking. I might drop the weight back for that final set. I'm only going to do two sets on this because I am doing a higher rep range, and higher rep ranges are typically more fatiguing, and you also get more total stimulus, I find, in a single set when you're doing more total repetitions. So I'll do one more set of these and that'll be on to the results. Considering doing a drop set, but I can't be bothered, to be honest. And the additional benefit it's going to provide me for the trade-off in the amount of fatigue it's going to cause at this point of the session just really isn't worth it. So I'll call it there. I haven't recorded this exercise in this gym for a while, so I don't know if I've set the camera up right, but we will see. Try to step back a little bit on this set. Try to overload the shortened position a little bit more. Definitely worth. It's a lot harder. Oh.